Five, four, three.
Satan says so.
Two, one.
All right, everybody.
Hey, welcome back, folks. What's this? What episode are we on of?
Episode 63.
31.
30-something.
30-something already? On the anniversary of our 30-something podcast, welcome, folks, to... What is the name this week?
As good as it gets.
I guess we're sticking with that.
We need a name podcast.
There's already the No Name Podcast. There's several of those out there.
I'm Charlie.
I'm Mike.
I'm Justin.
I'm Al.
What?
He's Al.
Satan's
dude, that was
here.
Great.
Satan's here, by the way.
Kind of looks like Mike, but we always knew that. Now it's really...
Well, it beats, you know, we could always do a checkup on Vince Neil. Should put Vince Neil singing through the modulator.
Could you do that?
I could sure as hell try.
Try with the mic.
Yeah, let's try this.
Did you hear that? I just heard another subscriber falling off.
Oh, man, I can hear.
Hold on. Let's get some Vince Neil going here first.
Can you guys hear me?
I think. Are you,
I'm up.
Okay.
All right, well, that...
it's still doing regular. Oh. Try to find it first. Okay, now wait.
That actually sounds better.
Oh, no. Now the solo comes up.
Guys, listen to that Satan music.
I know, right? Are you playing that record backwards and listening to the Satan words?
All right, I gotta fix my situation here. Hold on. Turn my volume down. There's no fold on this podcast. Thanks, homie. Let go of my
hat. I'm glad I came back this week.
This is
really organized.
It's falling apart.
Yeah. This is bad. That's why we have no subscribers.
I don't blame you.
I don't blame you.
That's the sound of three more falling off right there.
I still think we can use monk fruit as our name.
Monk fruit?
Yeah.
Nobody knows what that means.
Yeah, you can look it up, man. Jeez.
Okay, but like no one's gonna go.
That makes
this
it
one's named monk fruit.
It makes it
easier. It's easy to remember, and just brand it. Just
am I on? Okay.
Let's just name this the Let's Go Brandon Pod. You know what? There's probably a million of those already.
Yeah.
The Let's Go Brandon Podcast.
What are you doing?
Could you turn him down further?
What you doing, man?
Mike's spiky.
I'm spiking?
You're spiking.
Oh, shit. Let me turn this down a little bit. How about now?
Okay.
Okay?
Yeah. Yeah. Oh, yeah. Okay.
That was kind of weak.
How was your weekend? Or your week? How was the...
Good.
It was good.
Uneventful.
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 Dude, this is badass.
This is just exactly what I pictured. I'm like, Mike's gonna be like a fucking kid.
Oh yeah, kid absolutely. In a candy store with this. Did you expect anything different?
No,
really?
No.
Come on.
We used to do that with the handheld tape recorder. You know, like the little mini.
I have no idea how this shit works. Either. I just push the buttons until that.
Yeah, right. Really just kind of mess around with it. But there was like 2 speed on that tiny cassette. And you record it slow or fast or whatever, regular speed, and then you when you play it back, you just switch it from the other one.
Can
so
you
sounds like a chipmunk.
Explain what a tape player is for the younger viewers?
Yeah, no, a lot of people don't know what tape cassettes are. They don't know why we videotape things. Like, why would you put tape on your cell phone?
Well, I don't know how to explain it. It's really technical. So,
Al, are you looking up the article of the day or what? What's going on over there?
I got my shit.
You're not your shit? You're like, I hooked the shit up. What else you want from me? I'm on break, motherfucker. All right. Am I still spiking?
Yeah. It's your beard.
Your beard's spiking.
Yeah, all right. That's it. The beard's gone next week. The beard's gone next week.
It's like, who are you, man?
Dude, it's clearly this pedal. Let me turn it all the way down. How about now?
Sounds good.
Am I spiking now?
It sounds the same.
No. Yeah, it sounds the same, though.
But, are you?
Yeah, see? So if I do this, now I'm probably spiking.
Nope.
No?
What don't know is Al gave you a fake soundboard to occupy you.
Yeah, he just wants me here sitting pushing buttons for the whole podcast.
Dude, it works awesome. I don't care what anyone says.
Right, so I'll pull. Anyone did their homework?
Hey, your turn.
What
your
homework? Turn next
week. Anyone did their homework?
We were talking about the
your
great
turn
reset.
Next week with it.
Okay. Yeah.
So.
Are we not talking about that?
What?
The great reset.
Well, whoever does the best this week gets to have the pedal next week.
Kind of.
I'm surprised your name's not on it already.
It is.
He's breaking out the crack, 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 crack. Little label.
Oh, the old school label. Old school, yeah. I should get one of those, yeah. No, mine's pretty new school. So you can see my soundboard's over there. It says Mike's soundboard on it.
Yeah, I'm glad Al brings it back every week.
No, it's nice of him to bring it back, but it is mine after all. So
you know what he does with that when he takes it home, right?
You know what? It's a don't ask, don't tell policy. So it's simple.
Well, I already asked.
Do you guys want to discuss how terrible last week's podcast was?
I think that was one of our best.
You watched views?
Yeah.
I'm pretty sure it was terrible.
The views we had?
It was great. We had like 3 views.
Because, it's right there in the title.
Oh, no, wait. We got 4.
Justin Quit is right there in the title.
But so I saw
And then the views went through the roof.
Yeah.
Yeah. It was amazing.
We were up like, there's 3 people watching and then 4 and then it went back to 3. So I guess somebody checked.
I unwatched.
Unwatched.
All right. So, no, to answer your question, Al, I don't think anyone did the homework this week. But what I will do is Google and then give me a random word.
Sissy G.
Toothpaste.
S-Y.
Toothpaste. I'm not going to sit here.
Dude, that is a random.
I'm not doing made up words, okay?
Okay, so.
I'm feeling lucky.
I guess I'll go because I'm the only one that's prepared.
How about I'm feeling.
Okay, so here we go.
Fine.
North Carolina woman fighting DMV to keep fart vanity plate. Or vanity. So she put in for this vanity plate, F-A-R-T, fart. And she was surprised when it showed up. It showed up in her mail. But about a month later, the DMV sent her a letter saying that they've been getting complaints about this vanity plate, right? So the DMV says, if you can tell us exactly what it means, we're just not going to assume fart means fart. If you can explain it, and we'll consider letting you keep it. Okay, so what'd you guys do? So they explain it in this article, but
what do you mean, what would I do if they came to me with a
vanity plate? It doesn't have to be far, but just saying you had a vanity plate, you got it, and then the DMV came back and said, we're getting complaints about this. So you have to come up with
an acronym?
Something.
Something that it stands for?
Something that possibly could make.
How about this? How about it's called the First Amendment? I'll put whatever the hell I want on my fucking plate. I mean, okay. I understand it if it's an actual expletive, but
driving is a privilege.
Freedom of speech is a right,
but not on my privilege.
So, just saying.
I feel like I'm watching tennis right now.
Well, folks, you decide. What do you think, Charlie? I'll pass it off to you.
I will take the F. Make it to a PH, because that's what Filipinos do. So then it would be Fahart.
That would be Fahart.
Fahart.
Fahart. And I'll please everybody. I'll please myself.
So you'll change
it. Well, I do that anyway. but I please everybody else with my pH. Yeah, I'll change
your degree, your pH degree.
My heart degree.
I would consider changing it, but I want to hear what these complaints actually are. They just don't like the word.
Well, there's way worse words.
Yeah.
Like, okay, look, if you're an uptight asshole, what state is this in?
North Carolina.
Okay, if you're an uptight asshole, move to North Carolina. How about that? We'll just put all the uptight assholes there. We'll fence it off. Okay.
I thought.
Are we moving to North Carolina?
Yeah.
Okay, I just thought
the discussion would be like more creativity, you know, when I'm like, well, what'd you guys do? And then you're like, I have my fucking right.
Okay.
Well, all right.
Maybe it will get creative. Okay.
It's all good. It's all good.
Go ahead, Justin.
If it was me, first of all, I would argue that why the hell not? There's worse words. Two, I would make up something that it stands for. I would totally lie just because somebody's making a big deal about it. Now, what that might stand for, I have no fucking
idea. Yeah, you need some time
to create.
What would you do, Al? Before you read the rest of it. Now, you're a little biased because you know the article.
Yeah, but like what Justin said, I'll try to come up with it's really an acronym for something. You know, just try to keep it.
I would change it to FVCT. And see how many complaints you get there. I would make it a competition as to how many more complaints I can get on my change up. I'd be like, dude, you guys are always hassling me on my vanity plate, man. What the hell's going on here?
How about PHVCK? You.
Yeah, well, you could do that too. Like, there's several combinations by changing the U to
EWE.
So.
Is there a number there you could put?
U? Like, F K E W E. Never mind. Okay.
But my point is, if you don't like it's my right. My other thing would be I would change it to something more offensive that was acceptable because you're changing out certain words and then see how many arguments or how many complaints you get then and be like, what the hell, man? You guys are always calling me about my vanity plates.
Yeah.
I don't know. Make a game out of it.
Did you like that? Was that more creative?
That's fine. I mean, an answer is an answer. I was in my head, I thought, you know, you guys would get creative, but then.
No, the conservative guys got to come here. Like, you're trampling on my rights again.
My First Amendment.
No, but that's fine. I'm just saying, like, I assumed, but.
It's like, anyway, what do you think of this?
What
pony?
Would you make it stand for?
It's the First Amendment.
Like, funny and ridiculously. I don't know.
Okay, so anyway, this lady, or her name is Cindy, by the way, with an S. Cindy.
That's messed up already.
See, she knows how to put screwy spellings on things.
So she got with her friends, and they came up with, it's actually an acronym, Friends of Adderville. Oh, I can't see.
Open your eyes.
Yeah. Friends of Asheville. Friends of Asheville Recreational Trails, or FART. They actually created they have a mailing list, a website, and merchandise.
Is this
brilliant?
Is this post letter?
Good for her, though. That's awesome.
Did they have this before, or was
it
after?
It was after. And they had their first meeting, and 15 people showed up.
Yeah, I mean, you got free advertising. Why not?
Yeah.
At least free local advertising.
Yeah, so they got creative with that, and they have yet to hear back from the DMB on whether she can keep it or not. But I don't know. In my opinion, I think she deserves to keep it.
How do you think the people at the DMV felt sending that letter? They were like, Jesus Christ, what?
Yeah,
I gotta send this out
here. I just wanted to work for the government and the DMV, and now I'm trampling on people's, you know, First Amendment right. I feel like a real jerk.
I want to do my part.
Or they're sending it out saying, and she probably didn't get the shot in the mail.
Yeah, exactly.
Are you wearing your mask when you wrote that word down?
Exactly.
For your vanity
No, have you noticed? Oh, we could touch on that a little bit. You notice how the mask mandates are going away? It's all perfectly timed. Perfectly timed, just like I said it would be with the election.
The election.
The whole, you know what it's called.
Yeah.
It's going to be gone by election time.
Mask is unpopular.
Because my thing on that,
there's a party out there, and I won't mention who they are. But
80s party.
They're trying they got to come up with something good that they've accomplished in the last couple of years. But
my biggest problem is the mindless people, like the people that were like, "Oh, you have to wear a mask. You're endangering me," because now it's not being pushed. They fell right back in line with, "We're good." You know what I mean?
Yes. Yeah.
Doing no research of their own, just whatever they're hearing is gospel.
That's exactly.
That's what I don't like.
It's pretty crazy.
It's not an issue for many people that I've had conversations with. Now it's like, at work, we just went through, now we can go without masks. The people that were pushing them are like, they had no mask on last week. So,
did you smack them? Put your mask back on.
Well, in a clean room, I would work with my mask down from now on.
Even in the hallways. I mean,
it was weird.
So you had to wear it in the hallways too?
Yeah, we wore it in the hallways.
What about in your cubicle?
If people were around, we were supposed to, but I never did.
Like in the ASM cubicle during pass down, did you have to wear it?
No, and we don't do pass down in the cubicle.
Oh, sorry.
Sometimes. But
what's the pass down?
You used to. Sorry, the process has changed since my class.
It's just, you know, mind reading. We can just transfer the data.
Oh, that's right.
The next shift. We don't have to.
That's right. I forget. This is bullshit. Why am I still here? It's freaking 6:30.
Did you get that TPS report?
Gosh, though, talk about it. Man, that's the employer I work for now. Jeez, man.
Yeah.
I put that like, don't forget the cover sheet on your TPS report. It's in the signature block of my email now. So, because really there's a lot of pointless processes. But anyway.
That's funny.
Okay. It can be like weeks of a change process to do a 5-minute change. It's ridiculous. But anyway, that's how it works now.
Yeah.
That's all right. Cool. Well, that's good. No, what I was going to do.
Thanks for tuning in.
All right. Have a good week, everyone.
Yeah.
Bye-bye.
Okay. We'll talk to you later, guys.
Satan's back.
I was going to do toothpaste and then I'm feeling lucky on Google.
Okay, I can shut that off now.
Mike's got a new toy. If you guys,
you can't just type a word and say I'm feeling lucky now. You have to type I'm feeling lucky. Snake. Really? So snake came up and it's like play. So it's like this the old school Nokia game Snake. I don't know.
I think we should. How spend about the next Gary? 20 minutes,
huh?
Just of you playing Snake, but no one can see that you're doing it.
Yeah.
Ready, go.
Emotional damage.
You can't say that.
I'm sorry.
Yeah.
How about that?
LGBT.
Can I have a list of words that I'm not allowed to say anymore?
It's a long list.
Midget. Like, I never thought we'd lose that one.
You'll just sit there and not say a word if I give you that list.
When you bang on the table, it hit kind of like my bone here in the head like that. You know that funny bone?
Not like, so funny electric bone. Shock up your arm there? I have that effect on people. Oh, God,
do that again.
I have no idea what this is. Play. Oh, yeah.
Okay.
And you're doing it. That's the best part.
Yeah. Look at this.
Oh, yeah. Look. Oh,
see how
yeah.
it grows with each little thingy that you
Let's eat? Just ooh and ah while he goes through.
Ooh. Okay. Ooh. Oh, yeah.
Oh, that's amazing.
It. You can't hit the wall.
The pooch
you're
on
like
that.
Low. You're like Jason Newsted in the fucking Metallica. Like. The Justice for All album. We just turn your bass down. Just get it off.
Was he got not enough bass in his voice?
No, it's low. His is like really low. I boosted it up.
Is it all the way to
Hello? Okay, then you spike there.
We'll turn it all the way. Maybe his voice just isn't deep enough.
Yeah.
Hero Priest.
It doesn't get any higher than this one.
Hero. This is just my normal voice. Look how high it is. I'm not even like screaming, man. It's like spiking up.
You want the voice modulator?
I'm gonna
It'll deepen your voice.
You sound like
a man. It's going to be Barry White for me all weekend.
Oh, yeah?
We're going to be practicing.
Sweet.
Oh, yeah.
Let's see what this does. Oh, there's your echo.
How many voices?
There's a lot of shit in it. Oh, that's grunge.
Yeah.
Thickness.
There's thickness.
Ooh, there you go.
I like it.
Is there a lot of girth in that one?
Oh, yeah.
Breath.
You play with a pedal too, it'll like modulate depending on the setting.
I like the monster.
Wow. This is a good go-to.
Wow.
Envelope.
Wow.
We're doing a porno here. No.
Wow.
Yeah. Wow. All right. I think we're done with this one. Let's shut it down. Let's close it.
So, no. What else y'all want to talk about here?
Let's take some.
Let's take some questions from the audience. We'll see what kind of comments and questions we got.
I forgot to put a L in that takes. I wanted to talk about the Val Kilmer movie, Real Genius. Do you guys ever?
Who's seen Val Kilmer?
Is that where he had the God voice with the popcorn at the
That's
end?
That's what it sounded like. That's Kent. Why
he's like Kent.
Kent. Who is it? It's God.
Yeah, it's like one of his first starring roles, right?
Yeah,
it was one of them, if not the first.
Yeah, yeah. But he did a lot of spoof movies. He did that Top Secret movie.
Oh, I love that.
Yeah, that's another great that one.
It was the guys that did Airplane and yeah. Naked Gun.
Yeah.
They did a World War II spoof, whatever.
Yeah, it's one of the funniest movies.
He's from the Philippines, ladies and gentlemen.
Spliff? Just
give him a break.
There's this one scene.
Did somebody say spliff?
Spliff, light it up.
When they're sitting in the train and Val Kilmer's looking outside in the train station and the train's about ready to go. It's like and you see the train moving, but then the station ends and you just see the background. It was actually the station that was moving. The train wasn't going anywhere. Jeez.
I love that movie. I do love that movie.
You love that spiff?
I think you just ruined it for Al, though. He's never watching that again.
Hold on.
Carry on.
No, I don't want to carry on if you laugh at my shit.
No, I gotta get.
Come on, Charlie.
Damn, man.
Yeah, Charlie.
I'm
alone
with the podcast, I think. My nose is running.
See, I like those.
My nose is running.
Those movies when they play a serious part and then they throw the jokes in. If they try to make it too obvious, it doesn't make as good of a joke. Like when they did Airplane. They played everything serious. You have Leslie Nielsen, who is a very serious actor.
Don't call me Shirley.
It's funny you brought that up because I watched like 25 of Frank Drebin's most famous quotes today. Dude, and you forget like how many awesome one-liners there are. So,
oh, man.
Who are you? How'd you get in here? I'm the locksmith, and I'm a locksmith.
who else was in Naked Gun?
OJ.
That was actually OJ. It's funny, like looking back and seeing OJ in there. It's like,
Man, he was funny too.
I think he had on the Bruno Mollies in that, didn't he?
The what?
The gloves?
No.
The shoes?
Oh.
Oh. I didn't even know what brand.
No, that's a classic flick. So yeah, and that's why it's coming up in my feed now on YouTube. So like Frank Drebin, I shot twice once.
Oh, since we're on this topic, favorite comedy movie.
Oh shit!
Maybe like top three, or top five. Doesn't have to be like one.
Dude, I don't know that I can. I'll have to throw out the most recent one.
I gotta throw Dumb and Dumber in that.
That's definitely in there.
Yeah.
Blazing Saddles for me. Airplanes up there too.
Yeah. I'll go with what I watched recently, which was Spaceballs.
Oh God, that's great. Yeah,
that's classic.
I forgot how freaking hilarious that was.
Oh man.
So
that's hilarious.
Combing the desert.
Yeah. The thing is that when I sent out that meme with Dark Helmet and then the reporter from AP in Ukraine, almost like I sent it out to like 5 or 6 different group texts and almost everyone came back with, I see your Schwartz is as big as mine. My family, I don't think my family understood what it was until my brother. He'll let sort of the family text like roll for a little bit. I think he shuts his notifications off and stuff for it. So when he happened to look at it, this like probably a day later, he's like, I see your Schwartz is as big as mine. And I'm like, all right. So my brother's seen it. My parents are probably like, oh, I don't understand it. And I'm like,
I think that's what I said when he sent it out.
Yeah.
Yeah. It's like my dad, I don't understand why my dad doesn't understand it because he loves Mel Brooks movies, but
oh no,
he likes the older Mel Brooks stuff, History of the World. Yeah. Well, I don't think he watched Spaceballs. It's like too new for him.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Was that 80s?
84,
86, something like that.
Yeah. Something like that.
Low-key funny. You ever watch a movie called Real Men? John Ritter and...
Yes, I don't remember.
Is that the one where they had like glow-in-the-dark condoms and they were fighting?
That's,
okay. No, that's...
That's a different
one. What the hell is that called? He was an alcoholic and always sleeping around. Remember.
John Ritter was funny.
But that was fucking funny. That movie was freaking funny.
What's it called?
Oh, Jesus. A John Ritter.
Just look up all the John Ritter movies. Well,
for the record, Spaceballs was 87.
But Real Men. Real Men, if you haven't watched that. That's hilarious.
Let me put John Ritter movies. He's got only a limited number of movies.
But yeah, I have that movie. It's freaking hilarious.
Which one?
That fight scene with the glow-in-the-dark condoms. That's how you see fucking condoms going around.
Is it Real Men? Is that what you're talking about?
No, he's talking about Real Men, but...
It's got, what is it, John or Jim, the one that's alive? Jim? John? And John Ritter?
This is in the 80s. No,
John Ritter is not alive. Oh, Jim Belushi.
Yeah,
I just clicked.
Yeah, that movie's hilarious.
Skin Deep. That's what it's called.
Yep.
Well, that's the first one that shows up here.
Yeah. Skin Deep.
Yeah. 1989, Skin Deep.
Yeah, if you haven't seen it.
I don't think I have.
It's been a long time. I've seen it, but it's been a long time.
I'll let you borrow my DVD.
How about we have a movie viewing and a review next week?
Yeah.
Can we work Costco
reaction?
It's like people are like, well, I was like, hey, I'll get you a copy. It's like, I can afford the $3.99 for the movie. I'm good.
I think we should wear theme costumes, though, if we're going to. Like, not even matching the movie.
No.
Like, just whatever.
We all come in Star Wars attire and we review Skin Deep.
Masterpiece.
Got it.
Lower.
4,000.
Well, you know it's good because it's rated R. So that's back when they would show a little tasteful side boob in the movies.
I think there are a lot, actually.
Speaking of that, the Revenge of the Nerds movies, Porky's.
Oh, yeah.
Classic funny.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
True.
Nerds!
Yep. So watching this sitcom. Never mind. I forget.
King of Queens.
No, it had a
sitcom, Three's Company.
Had David
All
Spade.
All in a Family.
Had David Spade in it.
Oh, Saturday Night Live.
That's not a sitcom.
Anyway, he walks in and the guy who plays Booger is sitting at the cafe table. He walks in and he asks a question. He's like, "What the hell is Booger doing here?"
He doesn't know.
Like, everyone knows him as Booger.
Booger's in Risky Business before Nerds. Risky Business with Tom Cruise.
Well, because he was the buddy.
Yeah.
That was getting all the hookers in the house. Yeah. That's crazy. He was also in Better Off Dead, John Cusack. Mm.
That's another classic.
That's a classic.
Yeah. That's a classic
that
movie.
Car
skiing. Oh, yeah, the Camaro.
Yeah.
I can't believe he drove in the snow.
Rules of engagement is what I'm thinking of. David Spade's like a ladies' man. And
that's a far
A wannabe ladies' man. Let's just say.
Okay.
That's like Neil Patrick Harris and whatever that show was.
How I Met Your Mother.
How I Met Your Mother.
Yeah. He was freaking hilarious in that. Yeah. Challenge accepted. That was a good sitcom, yeah, too, it was, man. Good.
I never watched it.
Yeah. I don't
There's watch, a lot of shows I that I didn't TV. Even get to.
So are we going to do that? We're going to watch a movie?
We got to watch Skin Deep.
I think that would be a good one. We'll
I'll research that. What it costs on Amazon. Since no one does their homework. Motherfuckers.
It's free.
Is it one of the free ones?
No, I don't know. I'm just learning stuff.
I just have to look for it. You guys can borrow it, pass it around. Borrow.
I was like, I'll get you a copy. No. Yeah, because it's in a $5 bin and then
that's
at
illegal.
Walmart. Not at the $5 bin at Walmart. It's perfectly okay.
If I burn you a copy, that's piracy.
Wait a minute.
That's piracy.
You took royalties from that movie, Be Notto.
Are you?
Or is it?
Be Notto.
C-Nato.
I saw this. I saw a movie a lot like Tsunami. It was called Be Notto.
I think that's going on right now in Russia.
Probably.
Yeah. B-NATO.
B-NATO.
Let me see.
You have a drum roll there?
No, we have the... what was that?
Actually, yeah. Actually, we do. We do the rim shot. Damn, I'm
different rim enough. Shot.
Damn, Al. There you're really go. Quick with those. You're quick, Al.
He can cut that, though.
I'll put it right in. Together. I'll splice it in.
He doesn't cut the film. He just changes the camera angle every day. Like, oh, it's been 3.5 minutes. Change camera angle.
Even though Al's not talking, I'm going to put my face on there.
I was rolling my eyes.
God.
Oh, here we go. Charlie's talking.
Here we my go. Go ahead, Charlie, I guess. So if you have Amazon Prime, it is a Watch Now feature film.
Which one?
So Skin Deep.
There you go.
Yeah, I haven't watched that in a long time.
I'm going to watch it tomorrow classic. While I'm working.
It's classic, yeah.
What year was that one?
It was the
80s. 1989.
89, wow. Damn. No, it's freaking hilarious. It is hilarious. You're like, you wonder why John Ritter didn't make more movies.
You know? I know he's a pretty funny dude, man. You know, he just died too young.
Yeah.
Yeah, that was too bad.
Yeah, it's a Watch Now on Amazon Prime.
All right, let's do it.
All right, so we're going to review this.
Are you leaving
right now?
Week?
All right, guys, it's going to be a 2-hour podcast. We're going to review. No, it's only 1 hour 40 minutes. It's got to be more interesting than this podcast. Just watching us watch this movie.
I don't know. Well, we can make something happen.
So in 2 weeks, Al is going to Ukraine.
Yeah, they need my specialty. My
you and Steven Seagal.
Yeah, we have to. Straighten things out in the Ukraine. It's getting out of hand. So
you know what we should do? We should set the watch party with like just the silhouette on the back of our heads watching
like
that.
Mystery Science Theater.
Mystery Science Theater. Yeah, Mike, Justin, Al, and then Charlie.
And then whatever like, you want to say just comes up in a like text like a
subtitle.
Like a subtitle.
Subtitle. Yeah. I hit it with my accent just comes up. Yeah, can we do that? Do you know how to work that out?
Maybe.
Are we allowed to show a movie, though? We're not allowed to show a movie, are we?
No, you have to, like, splice it up in, like, 10 minutes.
You can only show, you can only show segments that are so long.
Fair use.
I don't know what that is. Al's read the entire YouTube contract.
Yeah. That's how smart he is.
And what we'll do is we'll just, when we hit that limit of, like, 3 minutes or whatever it may be, or minute, whatever, then it'll just be like, to continue, go to this link. And then we'll just make people.
We'll just edit, and
we'll get hits on everything.
And then we'll start a Patreon page. I'll say, oh, let's go pay $1 a month. Watch this guy's reaction.
Do we have a Patreon page yet? We got to be there by now, right?
We can't afford it.
We can't afford free.
We have to work up to it.
No, I totally understand. Absolutely.
You don't have that privilege, that white privilege to have a. Because you can't have
where's
access
my history
to it.
At?
You're Asian, dude.
You're Asian?
You're Asian.
What?
You're Asian?
What about the reasons?
You're Asian.
You put it in your Asian.
What about the reasons? I was busy.
Put it in your Asian.
Whoa.
Wow.
Sexy stuff.
Let's see how much subscribers we have. Oh, 13. That's a good number. We had 14.
We had 14. What happened? Justin?
Somebody hasn't subscribed.
Mike was using that voice too much.
He thought about it. It's like, let me subscribe. No.
It's probably that girl I was hanging out with finally got wise.
Oh, Heather? She's the one that unsubscribed?
Possibly.
Go look up. I mean, that's not very many subscribers. Look them up. Who do we have? I guess.
If you're watching, I miss you, and please resubscribe.
Don't simp, man. Don't
you
simp.
You gotta say it more sincerely than that.
We'll track them down. We'll dock all our subscribers. Show up at their house.
Dox them. We're gonna post the email.
Where is our
physical address? The phone number.
I'm having a hard time finding our channel. Jeez Louise.
You didn't even subscribe to it. That's
you're the one that unsubscribed.
Bullshit. Telling you, I subscribed on all six of my accounts.
That's why we got.
We talk 13. About pizza and chicken info.
You got to like
Colorado Roads and Drivers and Vince Neil, of course. You should have put, and of course, Vince Neil.
Okay, you can edit it. You have admin privileges.
Not on this computer, I don't.
So.
I got a good. Is it only on the device I logged in on first, so only on my cell phone?
No, you should be able to do it here. Yeah. You can switch accounts.
Should be your account, right?
You have to go to YouTube Studios, I think.
It's cold down here. Nice. You pay your bills?
I know, man.
You guys are always bitching. It's cold. I put the heater on. It's too hot.
It's cold. Fine. It's fine. It's fine. Yeah. It's like 12 degrees.
Bless America,
man. I didn't say anything, Mike.
Actually, it's 7 degrees.
I'm still blaming you.
Seven.
Right now?
Yeah.
That's outside, but it's not inside 7 degrees.
Well, it's 9 degrees inside. The walls are insulated. That's fine.
I'm just looking for whatever.
Charlie and I was just standing outside for 2 hours.
Dude, I was 17. Doing a setup for one of my heists.
It's not cold. Just let me,
if I walk away, I gotta start that setup all over.
Aren't Hawaii and the Philippines fairly cold most of the time?
Yeah,
very cold.
I'm always griping 70. About how cold it is.
At night when it's raining, 70. How many views we got on that one?
What are you looking for, Mike?
What are you doing?
I'm looking for comments. So far, there's none.
We're trying to do a podcast here, Mike.
I'm looking for... You guys need me to talk?
You need...
I'm trying to play the Jamie role here.
Let's see what's on your home. On your...
13 subs because of my return. Laugh out loud. I don't think so, Charlie. That's right. I don't think so, Charlie.
I retained that 13th one because we had a 14th and then,
Don't kid yourself. It was all back. Allison. As good as it gets, podcast still. No, it probably was because of Allison.
Your social media isn't very powerful.
I know. It sucks.
It's minus one so far. Oh, I forgot to unsubscribe from that. That's what they saw when they saw your post. They were like,
I don't
know.
We need,
here we go.
We need.
Oh, we're minus one now.
We gotta look up.
Good job, Al.
You should have a thumbnail that's totally not what our podcast is about.
Like a breast.
That's what I was thinking. Like some girl in a bikini, and then Photoshop that 100%. In.
Sex sells. You gotta have oh, I'm gonna click on that.
Shots of him from behind.
You're like, what are all these assholes?
In a phone.
A little hair sticking out. My
as good as it gets. Yeah.
That's good pretty good.
Some woman in a bikini. Yeah. Clickbait. Let's do it.
Surprise, there was a...
All about the views.
Like that scene on Porky's when she's trying to fix the car. She turns around.
Yeah. I know. Don't watch that movie, folks. Especially that part.
It can be made today.
Yeah. No, hell no.
They were high school kids. They wanted to go to this bar, right? And they have fake IDs or something to get in.
Strip bar.
Yeah.
They're trying to get it to Porky's.
In a swamp or something.
Yeah, how they came about? The producer or director, I'm not really sure, but he asked these...
That's not how you start a story.
I believe it was the director. he asked, he just threw this out there. Probably it was like on a radio station or something, but there was no internet back then. But he asked these people, like, tell us like your freaking craziest high school stories. And so what you see in the movie is someone turned in their story, right?
Turned in their homework.
Or did, you know, it's a story, and he's kind of just spliced it together. And then I guess someone turned in that their story was about getting to the strip club, and that's what the movie is focused around. But everything, you know, doing the pranks,
like, oh, they went, yeah, out, yeah, yeah.
They're the hooker, right? And then the black guy comes in, like, supposed to be the husband, jealous husband, whatever. And they're all running out of the swamp naked, right?
Yeah.
What's his name?
Yeah.
Pee-wee? What's his name? There's that one character. I think it was like Pee-wee or something.
There was a Pee-wee.
And anyway, so all...
God, it's been forever since
I know, right? Yeah.
So all of that was someone's story. Their high school stories. Mm. Crazy, crazy-ass stories, but...
They kind of did that with American Pie.
Yeah. That's probably like one of the last...
The last four
pieces. Yeah. Yeah. Like American Pie, and then was the... oh my God!
What's a Will
American Ferrell Wedding?
American no. Wedding.
The Will Ferrell movies too.
Yeah, they did.
Step Brothers,
like old school and all
old
that.
Old school, yeah.
Super Bad, Super Bad.
Oh yeah.
That, yeah, those are probably, yeah, like the last ones.
It didn't cross the line. Like,
the last one. Yeah, so yeah.
I mean, they're like drugs, like, you know. My minor's doing. Oh,
that's
doing,
good because my dick's on my back. That's about this.
What do you mean the last what?
Like that, those types of movie where they're like crossing along, you know,
kind of risque.
Yes, nudity.
Sexually.
Like Superbad did. I mean, it was drugs,
back
right?
When they had real nudity, yeah, before they started showing like fake ball sacks and stuff like that.
Yeah. I mean, there's minors trying to get
getting
beer,
girls
right?
Drunk and having
about like getting laid and drugs and underage drinking.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, when the generation that did it grew up to adults and then just taught their kids don't do this stuff.
Yeah.
Yeah, because that's how I had you, and I don't wish that upon you.
Wait, is your dad?
Yeah, exactly. You never would guess, huh?
Yeah, well, the beard kind of threw it off.
Well, I just hit puberty recently, so my beard grew out.
Damn. Give me some of that genetics. What if you try to do that? They do so many remakes. Somebody's got to try, and
that's all they make anymore, Charlie, is remakes. They've made every movie on planet Earth already.
This type of genre of movie, like high school risque, like, you know.
Dude, it won't sell these days because it's all bad and taboo.
You
can't say that. You
can't say that.
They're trying to rape that girl.
Yeah. It's going to get a lot of hate, but like Rotten Tomato, right? They're going to give it a 0. But then the
audience got like 99%.
Yeah, the audience, it'll be awesome.
That's how it's going to be.
Just self-publish it. That'd be great. I think this is probably what my next film project is going to be, man. Charlie's Adventure. Tsunami 2.
The buzz is back. There you go.
Tsunami 2.
Oh, that was cool.
You like that one? That's a robot.
The robot.
The robot.
Tsunami
2. Yeah, robotic bees. That's going to be the next.
It kind of reminds me, like, if you had a combination of like Porky's movies and then like heavy metal, something like that. You remember that cartoon?
Oh yeah. It was like, man. Apocalyptical or something. No, that was a band. Never mind.
Apocalypto.
Oh
no, the cartoon.
That was a completely different.
That's
movie.
What I said. The movie cartoon. Heavy metal.
Yeah, heavy metal.
It's like a rated R movie.
Yeah.
They had like sex, drugs, killings. And
I have that
too. You know, The Passion of the Christ. You know that one.
That's rated R.
Yeah, I have the soundtrack. You know, Blue Oyster Cult was supposed to do the soundtrack. They're on the soundtrack, but they're supposed to do the whole soundtrack. That's why the album Fire of Unknown Origin, when you look at the album cover and then just like,
it looks like monks,
like guys in robes, like a coat, and with a blue ball, the sphere.
They're holding their blue balls.
Yeah. No, but if you listen to that whole album, never mind. Okay, but anyway, but it turned out like they decided to get all these different bands, right? Cheap Trick's on it, Black Sabbath's on it, Sammy Hagar, Blue Oyster Cult,
and heavy metal.
That's the soundtrack.
Cardi B.
Cardi B. Yeah.
Queen? Did they get Queen?
Doja Cat. I'm not sure.
I don't think so.
No. They're, yeah. It's a good soundtrack. It's an awesome
Queen's soundtrack. Not really heavy metal, but I mean, I don't know. What would you categorize Queen?
That's like a, well, they kind of covered rock and roll, every genre, right?
Yeah, like
they did like rockabilly, Crazy Little Thing Called Love, and then fucking opera,
yeah,
and disco, Another One Bites the Dust. They, you know, Sheer Heart Attack. What the hell is that? They did like a hard rock song that Metallica covered. Oh my god, I have it in my head.
We'll come back.
Last Caress.
Last Caress.
Going back to Jesus.
I am evil. No.
That's a good song.
Oh, man. I have a question for you guys.
Sheer Heart Attack, right? Wasn't it Sheer Heart Attack?
Talking about Jesus, I got a question for you guys. What if you actually were there when Jesus performed all of his miracles? Let's say in 2022. I mean, you get to be the craziest person alive, like, to meet somebody and then, dude, did you just heal this person and this guy's freaking walking again when he's been paralyzed since he was born?
People wouldn't believe it.
Right.
That's
especially skeptics. Even if you videotape.
Even if he went on Rogan.
Videotape. Hey, you videotape it with your phone.
That's actually one of the things. So, like, the question is, if you had a time machine, like, going back in history, like what events would you want to see? And that'd be like on my list. I would want to see Jesus Christ. You know, I'm not, you know, regardless if I believe
I can see it happening. This is how it is. Like the portal opens, you walk through, Jesus Christ.
No, it's like whether I believe like, in
yes.
Him.
Yes.
Yeah, whether I'm religious or not. Like, I'm not going to say like where I stand on religious, but, I think that'll be interesting.
I think it'd be really interesting. Yeah,
interesting.
Like I don't practice any religion. Raised Catholic.
And, oh, here we go. Start out in the second grade.
All right.
Back in the Philippines. That's it. That's all. I'm
now you're
say.
A heathen.
Tell us about you learned English and you came to America.
Wow. He still doesn't know English.
You guys do this?
The bullying.
Why you do this to me now? Why I try to talk and you. And I always revert back to my Filipino accent.
Well, you notice how Al kept it short and sweet. He just kind of said, I'm not going to say where I stand on it, blah, blah, blah. And then it was done.
How long
like,
was I
wrap
rambling?
It up.
How long was
well,
I
this is preventative. That's all it is.
No, I'm going to, I got to tell my story. I can't just cut it.
We got to get those
we'll have to wait for a whole podcast on the next one.
Nah, I don't know what the hell I'm talking about. But I think it'd be really cool to...
we need those clocks like when they play chess, you know, you hit it. It's like okay,
mine
that's
will
your
be
time.
Like 15
that's
minutes.
Your time. So, okay, done.
Say,
my
Charlie,
time. My
Charlie,
time.
You're what's supposed up? To be.
Come on, Charlie.
Wait, Charlie. Come on, Charlie.
Envelope.
That sounds like one of the out of box.
Come on, Charlie. Come on, Charlie. I'm trying to hear these different sounds.
Come on, Charlie. Let's go.
There you go. You better pray that Satan.
Satan.
Satan's coming for you.
Oh, yeah.
Actually, that's what God would sound like, right? All powerful. Hey.
No, hey. That sounds dark.
Is that the sound of a loving and feared God?
It doesn't matter.
It sounds like a feared God, but not a loving God.
Alvin, stop touching yourself.
Alvin, stop touching yourself.
It is yes. God.
Oh my God.
I can't help it.
This is definitely the devil. You're like,
Al, touch yourself some more.
I'm a sinner.
Slap that ass.
So I think all of us would agree that would sound
give me
like
just a second.
Something like a bad guy voice, right?
Yeah.
How could you use that voice? What if you put it in a context of like a hero? Would that work? Like if somebody had a voice like
no.
that?
No.
Yeah, but we'll try it. Like, use like Braveheart. Like, they may take our mask rights, but they cannot take our freedom.
Freedom. Well, they didn't
do it
right.
No, they didn't do it right.
Freedom. No.
You gotta get it right. Freedom. No, see, it's not
dude,
right.
You really, like scare all your like.
Freedom.
Like they're picking on me. like
oh, the other voice.
So like make it sound like someone just a freaking wimp. Stop picking on me.
What is that Tom Cruise movie where he hit the fought the devil? He sounded like that guy. Do you remember that movie?
Devil's Advocate.
It's like one of the first movies that Tom Cruise did in the '80s.
Risky Business.
And like he was fighting the devil and had that same voice. Had that a girl?
Crossroads.
Vanilla Sky.
Who was in it?
I'm trying to look now. Dang it!
There's a guy named
Tom. Charlie's talking. Just started playing slacks. The outro.
Ooh, Fred's got slacks. Fred's got slacks is gonna be a hit.
On the highway, on the byway, Mr. Robocop.
I don't get that.
Trying to think of some else.
Devil can't ride a love song.
How do you turn his mic down?
Time. Oh, the last. Oh, no, that's not it. The last samurai.
The last.
Who was in it? Who was in it, Charlie? Who was in it, Charlie? Charlie. Keanu. Come on, don't let all the guessing with be between not, for you and your phone. You're not
thinking of Keanu Reeves?
Come on. Who is it? Who was it? Who was in it?
Wait.
Fred. Come on, Fred.
There was a...
Tom Cruise. Okay, so let's Google Tom Cruise. Okay. How do you spell
that? Cruise. The Last Samurai, bro.
The Last That's Samurai. The Samurai. Let's see.
I don't know who's in this. Tom Cruise?
The Outsiders?
Fuck's sake.
All the Right Moves? Legend.
Legend.
With the unicorn. Right?
The unicorn and the devil. Legend.
Loki.
What?
Loki was the devil.
Loki?
Loki was the devil. Loki. And the unicorn was the last unicorn.
Loki? What the hell?
Legend, right? That's what you're talking about? Legend. Legend.
Legend.
Legend, I said.
Legend.
Legend.
It is legend, yes.
Okay, there you go. Well, okay, next topic.
Okay, done.
You guys.
Charlie and his phone guessed it. I mean, with Al's help.
Wrong.
But I had that same voice in the... No, it's not.
It was called Loki. Just, the devil was Loki.
Just read us your text.
Just sound it. Sound out the words. Charlie, sound it.
Charlie, just go ahead and tell us a story, Charlie, so we can all take a break.
I already told the story. That's the voice.
That's Tom Cruise. That's the voice of Tom Cruise.
Why are you so mad, Charlie?
Why are you all excited? Jeez, so sensitive.
Take a chill pill, Charlie. Oh, Jesus Christ.
Come on, yes?
Oh, man, so uptight, man.
You like it tight.
Okay, that's just...
All right. No, we're not going to wrap it up. We still got
We can. This thing went south like 50 minutes ago.
Yeah. So, all right. That's it for everybody.
Yeah, oh, they're not watching an hour. They're not going to watch.
Yeah, they're not going to watch 5 minutes.
Just
they're
give
not
them
gonna
less
watch.
To not watch.
Let's come up with a topic for the next one, guys. I know that's the topic every week.
You guys will have a week to research a topic so for the next episode, so... You have 1 week.
That's we could talk politics, but I think that we could go down a lot of
That's
rabbit holes.
It's only political in the news right now.
Yeah, it is.
Yeah.
But what else is on the news? Even the last 20 years, like it's always the same.
Talk about the weather. It's cold.
All right,
Charlie, so, will politicize that.
Well, I don't know if I should kick off
it's
a whole
freedom.
Discussion.
I want global warming. I don't want this cold.
Yeah, it's contrails.
I really thought we were going to discuss the Great Reset. I thought that was the point of you sending that video out.
I thought, I'm not. There's I don't think. I think we're too. We're too far in to start talking about Ukraine and Putin. So
it's boring. Everyone else is talking.
What's going
about
on
it.
With Ukraine and Putin?
You don't know? Well, long time ago.
Once upon a time, when Russia got taken away. At least part of it. We called that the Ukraine.
There was this
they
crane.
Broke up.
Yeah. Oh, shit. Yeah. Oh, man.
Oh, man.
I'm really slow on this shit.
You have to...
Oh, yeah. Oh.
There's a group of aliens.
Anyway, we can make music instead. I think we should scrap this whole podcast idea.
Become a band.
Oh yeah, yeah, dude. I got all I need is this pedal thing here.
There you go.
I do want to say I appreciate our now 12 subscribers. Thank you very much.
Or zero, all of them.
They're dropping off.
Unsubscribe. And fast.
All right, everybody. That's it. We're gonna wrap it up. We'll see you guys next time. Peace.
Later.
Bye-bye.
Thanks. See you guys next time. Thanks for joining us.
Still blaming me for this shit?
Yeah, always.
Howdy, folks. Okay. Welcome to the podcast.
Why don't you get some coffee?
Get
some coffee. Wait.
Is as good as it is.
Change your leg, go fuck yourself, podcaster.
Okay.
You're so handsome on that picture, buddy.
What picture?
No, no.
Okay. I moved over so you'd have room for everything. Plus, he smells fantastic.
Check this shit, I can move it through software.
I'm moving the video? How are you moving me?
Hey, how do you do that with the computer?
So you can do that. Ooh.
Did you ever watch the old TV show, Hawaii Five-O, Justin?
It's been a long time, but... Oh my god.
I photoshopped my face from that to the...
You know what the reference is?
Why do you look high in that picture?
Because he looks high, dude. Like,
you know what the reference is?
For what?
Why he did that?
Because you're a cop?
Yeah.
Fucking narc.
5-0, bitch.
He's a narc.
5-0.
Are you 50?
Yeah. Dun, 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 dun. Such a great show.
If you need, I can just hold the microphone.
Okay.
Yeah. I think that would be best.
You're used to doing that, right? They hear it right in his mouth.
I mean, usually two like this.
Yeah.
God, you're terrible at all this.
I know.
You should take a week off. Where are you going anyway? Or is it a secret?
It's a secret.
You go to negotiate the ASML contract.
Madison Springs. Yeah, I just dropped... For this job interview.
Okay,
we don't need this.
Are you really?
Yeah.
Get a little closer.
Okay. My God.
You want to start it without him?
We're all here.
Coffee guy?
Who are we missing? I don't think we're missing anybody.
I thought we were all growing our beards out. I feel like you guys keep shaving.
I'm Asian. Can't really grow it.
That's pretty good. It's coming in.
Alright, do you want to... Give you an example of how long and you
test,
how much.
Test. Ooh.
This is like 1 week.
Oh yeah. Oh.
Ooh la la. Ooh.
Okay, what? Waiting on you, Mike.
One. Sorry.
Hey,
I was waiting on a stupid Keurig, man. This fucking thing. It's like, well, I think I'll make some coffee when I'm ready to make coffee.
You have a coffee maker down here? You should have just kept it.
Yeah, that's the one that
Al dropped.
We do,
but Al dropped it on the ground. It's been defective.
The one where Echo.
Hello? How's this shit work?
It's going about
that. Hey, how do you work this shit? Hey. That's pretty good.
What?
No, this one's not working. What the hell?
Well, because you hit the bypass.
Oh, that's how it works. Okay. Got it. Oh, I don't know what that is. Okay.
You might have to hit the pedal. That might be like volume.
Yeah. Oh.
There's an echo.
Yeah, it's this pedal here. Let me hit bypass. See, there's no more echo.
Okay. And then, you know, wait Justin's gonna be the few seconds, and then fade it. Fade it, right? And then hit it to shut it off.
I thought I went like this.
Yeah, just fucking hit it.
Yeah,
just,
you know that action.
Bring us in.
Sure.
Do it.
What? Wrong.
Yeah, let's start this over again. Come on. Don't screw it up this time.
You gotta count.
Oh.
You gotta count.
Five.
Don't
four,
screw it up this time.
Three.
Satan says so.
Two. One.